Hi everyone, it's Becca, and today I'm back on behalf of Wild Orchid Crafts, the Wild Bunch, to share another project with you guys, so I hope you enjoy.
For this project, I'm going to be using some flexible wire in 20 millimeters, some wire cutting pliers, scissors, some florist tape. This one is green, but you could use other colors if you like. I'm also going to be using some Wild Orchid Crafts flowers, and I will have all of the product codes in the description box so that you guys can head over to the site and check them out. So I am going to be using a variety of pink flowers, but you could use any other colors you'd like. I'm also going to be using some of these long stem stamens, some grass leaves, some rose leaves, and also some pliers and some of this craft wire, which is really thin and flexible. I've cut out two pieces of the wire and I measured this against my head and I've cut it so that it was about an inch longer than what I needed. I then shaped it into a rough circle shape and twisted the ends. I measured it to make sure it fits my head. And when I was happy with it, I twisted the ends so that it looks a little bit neater. And I did that for both of the pieces. Next, I'm going to go ahead and cover the entire thing with this florist tape. And I've cut out a piece and just started wrapping it around until I completely covered both of the circles. Now I'm cutting out a long piece of this craft wire. I'm going to hold both of my headbands together and just wrap this wire around as you can see me do here on the video. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to split this circle into quarters. So I'm going to go ahead and unite the headbands with the wire in four different places. When I'm done with that, I'm going to go ahead and start preparing the flowers. So the first thing I did was I grabbed this large wild rose and I attached two of the rose leaves to the back of the flower. For the next arrangement, I'm going to be taking one of these large rosebud, as well as some gypsophila flowers and also some of the stamens. I'm trimming off the ends of the stamens. Then I'm going to just place everything together. And using the stem of the flower, I'm going to just wrap this so that the spray of flowers holds together until I'm ready to attach this to the headband. For the next piece, I'm going to be using some leaves to create a spray. I've used five leaves and I just twisted the stems to hold together as well. Now for the larger flowers, I'm going to be wrapping this around over that wire that I had already used on the headband. And this is going to cover up that wire. So I'm just going to wrap this around the headband. And if you find it easier, you could use glue to attach these flowers. I'm going to take a small piece of florist tape and use that to hold the leaf spray in place. And I'm going to go ahead and wrap that around and then place a flower on top. And eventually I ended up using another spray on the opposite side, but you will see that a little bit later. And then directly above it, I'm going to be attaching the other spray that I had created. I'm going to alternate this all the way around the headband. So I'm going to add the leaf sprays on the top headband this time, and then place the flowers on top. And then the other spray is going to be attached to the second headband. And I'm going to do that all the way around. And you can see here, I ended up using two flowers to cover up the leaf sprays. And I'm going to continue attaching this all the way around the headband. And once I finish attaching all of the flowers, the headband is complete. I hope you guys like this tutorial. Please don't forget to check out the Wild Orchid Crafts website for these products. I'll also have all of the other links that you need in the description box. So thanks so much for watching. Catch you guys next time. Bye!